Hello my friends, welcome to the All Movies. Today I'm going to talk about one of the biggest American movie superstars, Sylvester Stallone, whose inspiring life story is a great example of persistence and dedication. Sly did this film out of desperation, after finding himself homeless for several days, sleeping in a New York City bus station in the middle of winter. In his words, it was either do that movie or rob someone. Instead of doing something desperate, he worked 2 days for $200 and got himself out of the street. Alan initially sent Stallone back to the casting agency after deciding he wasn't enough tough looking. Stallone pleaded with him and eventually convinced him to change his mind. Sly's first proper starring role, it was released under title Rebel in several countries in the 80s, attempting to cash in on the success of First Blood.
I just thought I'd move back so I wouldn't get the draft.
All right, but just don't make me throw you out.
Richard Gere was originally cast as Chico. According to Sylvester, he and Gere fought constantly, including physically, and he demanded Gere to be fired. He also stated that his payment for his role was 25 free t-shirts.
Well, yeah,
what's up, man? I didn't see you.
Some dame named Crawford says you know her?
Bullshit. He was stupid. He was an animal. All he knew were guns, Tony. That's what put him on top, and that's how he figured to stay on top.
Press anybody, but...
Hey. Everybody knows he was blown up by the resistance, you schmuck. It was on television.
Stallone wrote some of his own dialogue, and he and David Carradine did much of their own driving, since the custom-built cars used in the movie were not street legal, and the film's stunt drivers did not want to be caught driving them.
Sit him over there. I don't like it.
Cato. well, they actually call me Rocky. I really prefer that.
The ID says Elmore. Elmore Quincy Cato. You think you can carry all that?
Rocky, if you don't mind.
So tell me.
I gotta go back on my diet. This stuff is good.
Hey, I'm gonna tell you something. You look very good fat, you know what I mean? It does something for you. I'll tell you something else. That creep is running for it. Don't Betty know what's gonna happen to him if his brother don't come in first?
Roll. Apollo Creed on January 1st gives a local underdog fighter an opportunity.
After producers became interested in the script, they offered Stallone an unprecedented $350,000 for the rights. He had $106 in the bank and no car, and was trying to sell his dog because he couldn't afford to feed him, but he refused to sell unless they agreed to allow him to star in the film. Rocky's dog Butkus was actually his dog in real life. Rocky was a massive success with 10 Oscar nominations, including Best Actor and Best Screenplay for Stallone.
Wants to see Mr. That's right, Ken. Well, Mr. Kovac, Mr. Andrews is out of town, but he left a little message for you. You're fired! All of you!
Fired!
Newly a big star, Stallone was frequently hounded, screamed at, and sought out to be touched by fans during shooting. Thousands of fans gathered daily to filming locations chanting Rocky from behind rope and barriers, and frequently only a block away from the on-set filming.
Well, Senator, I can't go against that.
I'm gonna stop this, sir.
You stop nothing! We got everything in the world!
We got nothing going on!
We got everything in the world!
You're gonna kill us!
Sylvester actually wrote this before Rocky and tried to sell it to producers for years, to no avail. Once Rocky became a smash hit, producers were willing to look at the script, and Universal Pictures greenlit the production.
Not a broken pop.
You understand.
So lucky. What you did was a miracle. You're the luckiest man on the face of the earth. I want you to know that, Stallion.
Do I look lucky?
When Rocky is training for the fight, he is sparring with a smaller, quicker fighter. The sparring partner is played by real-life champion Roberto Duran. It took Stallone and editors over 8 months to edit the climatic fight scene so as to meet Stallone's approval. 800 local schoolchildren were used as extras for the scene depicting Rocky's run through Philadelphia.
Bust you, my mouth!
Come on, He-Man. I'll cut you, man.
I got the hots for you.
According to an interview, Rutger Hauer was told before filming that Stallone ran up building stairwells for exercise. However, during the subway chase, Hauer continually outran the American star, who is known for his competitive streak.
You use that bloody American style again here and you'll be barred.
Like, you play English, I play American.
Well, don't play the bloody American game. Get off!
Hey, what kind of game is this, for old ladies and fairies? I quit.
Sylvester lost about 40 pounds for this movie because he didn't want a prisoner of war to look like an Olympic boxer, and he felt he needed that weight reduction to perform the tasks of a soccer goalie. He broke one of his fingers trying to stop Pele from scoring a goal.
He's just another fighter.
No, he ain't just another fighter. This guy is a wrecking machine, and he's hungry.
In the scene where Rocky body slams Thunderlips out of the ring, Stallone admitted that he couldn't deadlift Hulk Hogan, so he had Hogan jump into his arms. He also revealed that his body fat was a remarkably low 2.8% during the shooting. This was intended to be the last Rocky film. However, due to the film's success, Sly decided to keep the series going. The first rough cut was over 3 hours long, and according to Sly, it was so bad that it made him and his agent sick. He wanted to buy the movie and destroy it, thinking that it was a career killer. After heavy re-editing, the film was cut down to 93 minutes. This version was ultimately released in theaters. In an interview, Sylvester once said that if there were any films he wished he hadn't done, this film was one of them. Although he couldn't stand the movie itself, he has stated that Dolly Parton was one of his all-time favorite female costars to work with.
Photographs?
Just photographs. Under no circumstances are you to engage the enemy.
I'm coming to get you.
To prepare for this role, Sly did 8 months of training for 4 hours a day. He also took SWAT combat, archery, and survival courses. Temperatures during filming sometimes reached 120 degrees and Stallone had to constantly deal with snakes, spiders, and scorpions throughout production.
I have to have the heart to stand in front of me. And to do that, he's got to be willing to die himself.
During a practice round, Sylvester told Dolph Lundgren to really go at it, like how normal boxers do for 15 seconds. He ended up with a swelling pericardia sac around his heart and had to be rushed to the emergency room by plane. His original cut of the movie was about 1 hour longer, but the final film, at 91 minutes, is the shortest in the Rocky series.
Your disease, and I'm the cure.
Die!
When Sly was on set, he was in fact literally directing the film, with George Cosmatos acting as the on-set director. He literally mapped out and planned a lot of the shots, including the speech where Brian Thompson calls Cobra a pig. The custom 1950 Mercury driven by Cabretti in the film was actually owned by him. Stallone was reportedly unhappy with the final film. In an interview, he said that if he'd directed the film, he would have changed the setting to an urban environment, used scored music instead of rock songs, and made the Las Vegas finale more ominous. Sylvester asked for a Gulfstream jet as part of his pay for the film. He got one. With its $63 million budget, this was the most expensive film ever made at the time of its release. During filming, Stallone had a close call with a spinning helicopter rotor blade. In fact, had he been struck, it would have certainly decapitated him.
You're being transferred.
Transferred where? What the hell?
No body doubles or stunt doubles were used during the filming of the football game sequence. Stallone was tackled repeatedly by some of the real-life prison's penitentiary extras during the scenes. As a result, he almost broke his leg.
Glad you could drop in. You like jewelry?
The glasses Sylvester wears early in the film are his own, not props. He usually wears contact lenses in his films. While filming the scene, in which the back of the SUV catches fire, the flames would not go out when filming was over. Stallone was so close to the fire that his hair was singed in places.
Stated, Mr. Balboa, it means that you've suffered some damage to the brain.
How long until he recovers?
The effects are irreversible.
In an interview, Sly said that he made the film out of greed. When he was asked to rate each of the Rocky movies out of 10, he gave this movie 0. He originally toyed with the idea of killing Rocky off at the end of the film. His salary for the first Rocky film was $23,000, for the fifth Rocky it was $15 million.
You should be so lucky.
Don't say that about the man I'm gonna marry.
You're not gonna marry that monkey. You're gonna marry the man I picked out for you, Bruce Underwood III. Forget it! Fine. Follow choose!
Sylvester, in his tribute to Kirk Douglas, recalled the filming of the scene where he hits Stallone in the face. After a swing and miss, he jokingly told Douglas to slap him hard. Let me have your best, whereupon Douglas proceeded to beat him silly. He said, I learned the hard way, never spar with Spartacus.
Get your hand out of here.
Really?
According to Stallone, Arnold Schwarzenegger tricked him into being in this flop comedy by starting a rumor that he wanted the movie himself. Sly admitted that he heard Arnold wanted to do the movie and, after hearing that, said that he wanted to do it. Later he understood that Arnie tricked him. He considers this the worst film he's ever done.
What's in him?
None of your fucking business!
Suits, socks, $100 million, the usual stuff.
Sylvester partly took on this project in an effort to help him conquer his fear of heights. Sneak preview audiences saw a scene where a rabbit gets killed by gunfire. Their reaction was strong enough for Stallone to invest $100,000 of his own money to have the scene reshot so that the rabbit escaped.
Simon Phoenix is an old-fashioned criminal. We need an old-fashioned cop.
Thanks a lot, you shit.
Sly described the cryogenic freezing scene as probably the worst 5 hours he had ever had on movie sets, as he was terrified. He wanted Simon Phoenix to be played by Jackie Chan. Chan declined, since he only plays heroes. Prior to shooting the nude scenes with Sharon Stone, as she was reluctant to take her robe off, Stallone had to bring a bottle of Black Death vodka that was given to him by Michael Douglas, and after half a dozen shots, they were wet and wild. It was his third highest grossing movie at the box office in the 1990s. In later interviews, Sylvester said he felt the film was supposed to be a comedy action film and demanded rewrites to make it even more comedic. The director and screenwriter, however, had intended a darker, more satirical approach, which led to many difficulties behind the scenes.
Los clavos de Cristo.
Mel Gibson was initially interested in directing the film. He mentioned to his friend Richard Donner that it was a really great script. Then, when Gibson got heavily involved with Braveheart, the project found its way to Donner. Donner claims the film would have worked better if he swapped Stallone and Antonio Banderas.
She's right.
She's always right. Female intuition.
Stallone said this would be his last action film because he was getting too old for the genre. One reason he agreed to act in this movie was to help him overcome his fear of confined spaces. His son, Sage, played Vincent.
Mind if we check up on Liz?
Yes, I do. I mind. I said I mind, Freddy.
Sylvester gained 40 pounds to add realism to his portrayal of the sheriff. He gained the weight by eating a steady diet of giant pancakes served at a local pancake house. By the time that reshoots were required, he had lost the weight.
For me. Who said there was a girl for you? I was talking about a girl for me. Don't you want your aphid beer?
Call me crazy, but I have a thing about drinking from the anus of another creature, okay?
Suit yourself.
Arnold Schwarzenegger was originally offered the part of Weaver. When Schwarzenegger wanted to be paid for the role, it went to Stallone, who was willing to do it for free.
Trouble just for listening to someone talking about impersonating a soldier?
Hello, Mr. Davis. My name is Jack Carter, and you don't want to know me.
One of the reasons why Sir Michael Caine agreed to appear in this remake to one of his best movies, as it afforded him the chance to work with his friend, Sylvester. The two had bonded when they made John Huston's Victory. The original screenplay was much more violent and focused more on the revenge element.
Different time, I'm different.
You will never be different.
Stallone originally conceived the film as a biopic of Brazilian driver Ayrton Senna. The original script was 220 pages long. When he was asked in an interview about films he would wish had not done, he listed this as one of them.
Joe Tanto has taken the lead!
Unbelievable.
You made my life hell. So now, I'm returning the favor.
After the movie was finished in 1999, Universal Studios screened it to a test audience. All the screenings got very bad reactions, so reshoots and story changes were being done. After test screenings for the new version also got negative response, it finally received a limited release 3 years after completion. The film was met with mostly negative reviews by most critics and was directly released to home video. It is Anthony Quinn's last film.
Mr. Stevens, good to see you again.
Thanks. Bags in the trunk.
Daddy Stevens.
The man himself. I mean, this guy, he's a legend.
The hands seen performing card tricks in the beginning of the film belong to director Damien Neenan and other real-life card mechanics. They also taught Stallone and Stuart Townsend how to perform their card tricks for the film.
My time on this planet is over. It belongs now to our youth.
Not if we control their minds.
Oh, we could, like...
Sylvester said in an interview that he asked his kids about the previous Spy Kids movies and if he should accept the role in the third installment. Due to filming schedules, many of the actors playing characters in the final scene were never on the set at the same time and were put together digitally.
He's basically been spoon-fed his opponents. No question in my mind, not only does Rocky win, but he wins knockout.
But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get.
The film was shot in 38 days. The very first thing to be shot was the fight between Dixon and Rocky. This was done because Stallone's 6 months training had to stop once he began to concentrate on directing. If the fight had been left until the end of the schedule, he would not have been in as good shape as he was at the start.
When you're pushed, killing's as easy as breathing.
Originally, Rambo was supposed to hold the M2 machine gun in his hands and fire it, but when fully assembled the weapon weighed 120 pounds. Sly was still capable of holding and firing it, but it was too cumbersome for quick movements, so it was mounted on the back of a Jeep instead. The first and only Rambo film directed by Stallone himself. It averages 2.59 killings per minute.
Good evening, everyone. My name is John Rambo.
What's that?
In a text.
Excuse me.
Get out!
Dead.
This is the first time that Sylvester Stallone, Arnold Schwarzenegger, and Bruce Willis have appeared in a film together, in any combination. The three action mega stars are longtime friends. This movie also marks Arnold's first film in 5 years, and he did his cameo for free. Stallone sustained 14 injuries making this movie.
All right, I got a very busy schedule. This better be good.
You sleep 20 hours a day, Joe. I think you'll live.
Okay, things I didn't want the group to know.
And then you would like follow me around.
I
would
say.
Look at you, and then you'd,
clap
you'd look
it. Clap
away.
It. Clap it! Well, okay, we're helping Revan. Now, how do you propose we do it?
Animals are acting.
What's she doing?
Saving this Chinese billionaire.
Oh, yeah? That's funny. So are we.
But then we have a sketching problem, don't we? Cut me loose. Frankenstein.
Sly explained that his casting was looking particularly for actors who had not experienced recent hits, as he likes using people that had a moment and then maybe have fallen on some hard times and give them another shot. Someone did it for him, and he likes to see if he can do it for them. Wayne Kramer was originally hired to direct in February 2011. After clashing with Stallone over the tone of the film, he left the production and was replaced by Walter Hill on April. Kramer's version was much darker than Stallone wanted. This was Sylvester's worst opening weekend gross in 32 years and his second lowest opening weekend gross of all time.
Welcome to the International Detainee Union Intake. I'm Warden Hobbs.
Hobbs. Where's Warden Marsh?
There is no Warden Marsh.
The idea of a movie co-starring Sly and Arnie had been discussed between the two men for many years, as far back as the mid-1980s. Different scripts had been pitched or written, but actors' schedules were not able to match up. Arnold's exit as governor and his cameo appearance in The Expendables prompted the two of them to revisit the idea of working together in both this movie and Expendables sequels.
You're a lucky guy.
Okay.
No, Mick! What are you doing?
No, Brad's going
with that. Brad's going with that. Stop! Oh, stop, man.
Most people think this film was a Stallone project, but according to Robert De Niro, he got the script first and quickly came to the conclusion that Stallone would be the best choice to play his opponent. Sly himself was actually quite reluctant at first, as he did not want to parody Rocky.
Pounding away.
All right. We're not going home. We're stopping a dealer named Victor Minns delivering a shipment of thermobaric bombs.
Oh, come on, man. That shit is hellfire.
Hey, routine stuff.
You know, why did you just pick me up on your way back?
We're a man short.
Unlike the first two films in the Expendables franchise, this film received a PG-13 rating instead of an R rating that received backlash from the fans. Sly wanted to reach a younger and broader audience with the new film. Since its release, he regrets rating, saying that it was a horrible miscalculation on everyone's part. He is quite certain it won't happen again.
When are you going to stop being a slave to your addiction? Really? It's a disgusting or impulsive habit, and that's why you don't have a girlfriend. What woman wants to kiss an ashtray?
Because his destruction is your salvation. His demise is your transition from Chekhov to journalist. You're a finger painting. Be a masterpiece.
But you gotta work hard. I swear to God, if you're not gonna do it, I'm out.
I want you to let it all out. Hey, everyone's ever disrespected.
Sylvester requested that Michael B. Jordan wear the famous American flag trunks that Apollo Creed and Rocky wore in previous Rocky movies to keep tradition in the Rocky universe. This is the first film in the series that is not written by Stallone, and also the longest film in the Rocky saga.
Bring me the captain's head.
I'll take yours as a replacement.
Oh, well, lots of ways, really. Chains, knives, guns. An enormous rock? You just lost the business of 99 of them by serving one.
Please, sir. Please.
Get away from
please.
Me. If you think I take pleasure in exiling you, you're wrong. You broke all our hearts.
I hold it true, whate'er befall. I feel it
when I sorrow most.
'Tis better to have loved and lost. Hey, Breslin. Good to be back?
No, it's bad to be back.
Despite being top billed, Stallone is only in the movie for approximately 15 minutes. The film was shot in 20 days. He said about the film that it was truly the most horribly produced film he has ever had the misfortune to be in.
Listen, why don't you just turn off your brain and let your heart do the talking?
Stallone and Dolph Lundgren trained like madmen for the filming of Creed 2. They have posted on their social networks videos of them physically preparing themselves as if they were still 30 years old. In a video published on social networks in 2018, the 72-year-old American star declares that he will probably no longer embody his iconic character on the screen.
What's our chances of getting anything out of this guy here?
Spotty at best. Paramedics came 50-50 when they got here.
Hey, I need you guys to get him down to the trauma center, right?
Yes, sir.
And no one talks to this guy except with me. Mr. Clark Jr., my ex-partner's son.
Where are you?
The film was shot in 4 weeks on a 20-day shooting schedule, and it was filmed at the historic Ohio Reformatory Prison, where The Shawshank Redemption was filmed.
You wanted me? You got me, come on.
You're gonna think about this every fucking day.
This is the first film where Rambo doesn't wear the iconic bandana, nor he doesn't have long hair. Originally, the movie had more and bigger action sequences, especially in the ending, where Rambo fights against many more mercenaries who attack his ranch. However, Sly didn't like how over the top the action was, so he scaled everything down in his rewrite to make it more realistic in order to focus more on the story and characters. And that's all, my friends. Hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching, and
live for nothing, or die for something.